This is the Galaxy Report for Saturday, August 26, 2006, episode 50. Welcome to the Galaxy Report. I'm Frank Asaka. My co-hosts this week are Flipside. Flip, welcome.
Hail.
You just copied that off of the thing from the pre-show.
I wanted to.
How lame. Come up with something original.
It is. It's my new thing.
Oh, great. Josh, make sure I mute his mic from now on. Our other co-host is Josh. Josh, how you doing?
Word up, home slice.
Oh, God. I guess it's
I was thinking you might go, "Hi, I'm Josh."
I'm just going to have to mute both your mics and go this alone this week.
Oh.
I think that might be best.
You going to go solo?
I might have to.
He's going to go Han.
Oh, God.
Hi, Mama.
It's not so much
Hi, up. Princess.
This princess isn't in bed, so she's joining us this week. She was laying on the couch, but now she's sitting on my lap. Anyways, let me go over what we have to look forward to this week. We're going to go through what you've been doing, go over some of the updates that are in-game, go over the news this week, then we have some miscellaneous features we're going to go through, and, I don't know, wrap up the show. We're going to shoot for an hour this week, aren't we, guys?
Yes.
Okay. We'll see what happens. All right, Josh, let's start with you. What you been doing in-game this week?
I've been sitting around waiting for this guy to log on most of the week, give him a Mando armor. You're gonna have Shod Legacy. No, I haven't. I just logged in 15 minutes ago just to try to get it from him, but I got killed in Rebel Base, the Weapons Depot on Talos because I logged out there.
Seem to do a lot of waiting for other people.
I do. It's not Gyren, it's someone else.
It's your entire game.
Do you get stood up a lot?
Do I what?
Stood up.
Stood up. Oh. No.
Only by chicks.
John.
All right, Flip, what you been doing in-game?
Pretty much closing in and finishing my alt's legacy quest.
Cool.
And just fooling around with my crafter. Because I'm just worried that things are going to be taken away from them and making things that I don't know if they're going to have later on, so...
Awesome. I actually got through with Corellia on the Legacy Quest finally, and I was really shooting. I wanted to get a chunk done out of the Talus, but then Xbox Live, or for the 360, they released Texas Hold'em on Live Arcade, and it was a free download for the first 48 hours. I'm like, what the hell, I'm going to give it a try. And I've sunk about, I don't know, more time into that than I have playing SWG this week, and I think I'm done with it, but I did get done with Corellia finally, so I'm off to Talus, hopefully tomorrow.
Well, and it gets a little better because you don't have to do this continual back and forth. You know, it's the next little tiny part that you want me to do. They give you a string of things to do, and that's what I like about the next part. Well near the end of Corellia, they start doing that because I think they heard a lot of people complaining that, you know, that nobody really likes going back and forth to do one thing, you know, have to do a string of things.
Well, I actually like the way they incorporated more of the missions towards the end on Diable Gurfle. I may have botched that up. But I really like the way they worked in, like the existing buildings that were in the city. And you did have to go, like, outside of the city some. But, you know, there's things like take this, you got the camera, you had to take the picture of the one chick, and then you had to kill her. And I thought that was a nice change of pace. And... take her picture and kill her.
So many things made it different. I wish you got to keep that camera, but and actually take pictures. That'd be kind of neat.
That was like that mission in Vice City, where you got to take a picture of the guy. with the hooker. Get away.
It sounds like a Lifetime movie, like some guy, like a photographer who takes pictures of chicks and then kills them. But,
well, no, that's Jude Law in The Road to Pediatrician.
Never seen it.
It was a good movie.
But
Tom Hanks.
Pediatrician? Isn't that perdition?
One or the other. What's pediatrician?
A kid doctor.
Something else.
Oh, wow.
Keep going.
Are you drunk this week? Did your breathalyzer fail?
I'm just tired.
Okay. At least we know that beforehand.
You know that movie, Road to Perdition, you know that part of it was shot in near West Michigan on the lakeshore? That's where Sherrick and I are.
Amazing.
Yeah, updates. Publish 2.5 went live this week. They did some changes to chat, the faction chat. A character must belong to the corresponding faction in order to join a factional chat. They added the profession chat. So you can kind of keep in touch, like if you're a bounty hunter, you can talk to other bounty hunters, ask them questions. It's a nice little feature. Players will no longer be able to assume chat moderation abilities in public chat channels. I didn't know that was an issue. Combat. Going to the prone position in combat can be dangerous if you fire an enemy NPC or creature while prone. I think we talked about this last week,
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, it doesn't work.
We went over how Locke had initially had put that in. Nobody noticed it.
Right. Profession Spy, they reduced the cooldown timer for the Spy special ability Vanish to 10 seconds. That's the one that they had originally added the cooldown timer, 25 seconds. People called it a stealth nerf. I guess Thunderheart explained it more as he was out of the office that day. It was kind of an unplanned thing for him being out, and they rolled it out, and he didn't get a chance to tell everybody about it, so that's their story. But they reduced it down from 25 to 10 seconds because of the complaints saying it was too long. Rage of the Wookiee quest fix. Always good, you know, can't go wrong with quest fixes. Which I still have not run into a bug on a legacy quest. Maybe I'm lucky.
Because you're so damn slow.
Well, you know, there's a few of them. I did Nostron quite quickly, and there was one where you're doing the droid part on Tatooine. You actually, some people who finished it quick enough got to keep R2's head, and you could put it down in your own house.
I have that.
But now that, what's that?
I have that still.
Yeah, I redid it with my alt, which is now up to Talus. You can't get the head now. You can't get R2's head because that
you
was like
the head.
No, there was a glitch. You got to keep R2's droid head, but now you can't get it anymore.
Oh, well.
So that was just one little thing I noticed.
Well, see, I think that's the benefit of doing it, like doing the missions the way I do it. Instead of like as soon as they release it and making sure you try to get everything done, you know, the day it's released, take your time. Let it take, you know, 6 to 8 months, because by the time you get to it, it's going to get fixed if it's bugged. That's my tip that's my Tuesday tip of the week. Wait 6 to 8 months before you do anything, so that way you can make sure, hopefully it's fixed by then.
No one's going to listen to you for 6 to 8 months.
Well, in fact, even if you wait, you know, maybe they'll update the quest to give you a better reward. People that have already done it get screwed.
Yeah, I always like that. The Rebel Space Station, Freedom Station, and Deep Space can be attacked and destroyed. You guys are space guys. True, not working?
It blows up.
Okay.
The hard points kind of suck. It's not very tough, but it blows up. They even made a Friday feature of it.
Yeah.
You're jumping ahead.
It's kind of ironic. It's a funny feature for something from 2 years ago.
Gosh, quit going 88.
Instant travel vehicle can no longer be called the Riot Trail, and when time limit expires for completing Corellian Corvette quest, players will be ejected from the Adventure Zone. So that's all we really received this week as far as updates. It was kind of a slow week from any kind of communication from the developers. I know they had the summit in Germany. There's also a game conference there. So I don't know, maybe they were busy, but it seemed like everything really slowed down this week as far as information wise.
I can indeed.
That is unless you want to count the GCW leaked info, which is it's not true. Which is our next topic as we move on to news and rumors. And Josh, if you don't want to talk at this part, that's fine. You're not supposed to say anything, so we're just
going to chime in occasionally.
Okay, we're just going
to. No, I'll pretend we're talking about WoW, and then I'll comment.
Well, in WoW they did something like this, and this is what I thought. You can always go, you know, that could be your out.
Okay, my out. Bye.
Well, this is the leaked info, and it seems pretty, I think, I don't know if it's totally been confirmed, if, you know, if this is true or not, but this is, the GCW changes that we, you know, tentatively planned for Chapter 3. Now, you know, some people are getting, you know, they're all up in arms about some of these changes, and you have to remember, this is just like, this isn't set in stone, this was just basically thrown out there, try to get some feedback on, you know, what the senators thought, and it wasn't, I don't think it was meant for everybody to see and critique it. But we're gonna do that because that's what we do. They're basically totally revamping the way the whole Galactic Civil War, points and rank works. Some of the things that they're gonna do, and Flip, anytime you want to chime in as I'm going through these, just jump on
and
in and let
I
me know
will,
what you think.
I will.
And if I think you're going on too much, I'll just tell you shut up. But NPC ground combat, boss and elite caliber NPCs within 5 levels will grant an amount of Galactic Civil War points. And I think this is one thing that people are worried about, because when's the last time you saw like a high level boss or elite NPC within 5 levels of a 90?
You know, most times, when if that ever even happens, it's not even like a chore to get by them.
Yeah, they are pretty easy. But, I mean, how often do you see them?
Never. I never. I do a lot of the missions. I've never really come across one. And if I do, I don't even notice. It's nothing special.
Ground PvP combat players will be able to battle each other for Galactic Civil War standing. The value of PvP kill will degrade with repeating killing of the same target. The value loss will decay over time. And basically that's what it does. They're trying to keep from griefing. You know, with the way this will work, you won't continue to get a bonus from clone camping someone and just like, you know, continuously killing them over and over and over again as they're weak. You'll get less and less points, and basically it'll get to the point where it won't mean anything to actually do it. So they're trying to do that to, you know.
Kind of like working out the PvP system works, where if you kill the person the same amount of time, same number, you know, keep on killing them over and over, you're not going to get a PvP score for it.
Right. And it makes sense. You know, you want to try to limit the amount of griefing that is possible. NPC space combat, defeating an NPC of equal or greater tier value will grant an amount of GCW points. How does that work now? Is space involved in the GCW?
Well, as far as I know, for just the basics, the only way really to get faction points in space, you have to actually go announce in space that you're declare it. Then you get.
That's what the kids are calling it.
Yeah, then you get the faction points. Otherwise, you're not getting faction points if you're declared.
Okay. Space PvP. Did I already say this? Yeah, space PvP combat. Players will be able to battle each other for like the Civil War standing. Value of a PvP kill will degrade over time. It sounds like pretty much the same thing as with ground, but in space.
And I really hope that they would really fix that, where it's not one kill I win, one kill I win. You know.
What?
Well, I mean, one shot, one. Yeah, you usually you hit one person if you're PvPing in space. You can hit them once or twice and they're dead. You know.
Yeah,
it's not a battle like on ground. It's different.
That's good. It's the ground game's foobar. I like, and space is supposed to be just one hit kill.
I wish it feels different, because I don't really feel, I mean, then you gotta go back to the station, wherever it is that you have your ship at, and then you gotta go all the way back out there if you wanna fight again.
Yeah.
I think it's more of a hassle than fun.
Because you're from Bloodfin, you don't know.
Ooh.
You don't have space cojones.
Ground PvP regions. PvP combat that takes place within a PvP region will periodically receive bonus points for participation. The value of the bonus will be determined by overall activity, unique activity, and faction imbalance. And I hope that really means that I hope they really incorporate cities into this. Maybe like a couple cities on each planet that are PvP zones. Give people a reason for taking over different cities. That's what I'm hoping for. Space PvP regions, same thing as ground, but in space. Player place GCW bases. Planetary control will provide a bonus to GCW standing, and base busting will provide bonus GCW standing, similar to a PvP region. Now, do you think they're just gonna bring back the other bases and just change the bioengineer feature, or do you think we're going to see something a little more similar to what the static ones are? flip.
Hold on. I just got called an idiot, I think, for the space thing. What can't you get a glancing blow in space, you know, a couple of times? Survive? Glancing blow by a missile. I don't know.
Well, you don't mess with space. It works.
It would be like being on the ground, if you could, like, target a person's leg and you aim at their leg and shoot at their leg so you could slow them down, or like hit them in the head for a headshot that would one shot kill them. It's not like that on ground, but in space it's similar to that. You shoot someone in the engine, you're more likely going to, you know, take them out than if you were to hit them in the wing.
Exactly.
Yes.
I agree with the guy who doesn't play space.
The guy that doesn't play space knows what he's talking about. We're talking about like placed GCW bases. What are you guys' thoughts on these?
Cool.
Flip?
Well, I got the banner that I guess now is bugged. Josh, are you talking about that?
No. We're talking about the leaked information that came from the GCW, and we were talking about player-placed GCW bases.
Oh, where am I? What am I thinking? I think I'm reading too much chat, not what you guys are talking about.
Yeah, you just gotta leave the
chat.
Yeah, you gotta leave the chat room closed during the show. It doesn't work.
Man, we're like 60 minutes.
Okay, let's go. Come on.
Go, flip.
Alright, say the question again.
I'm moving on. Rank, gain, and reward. They're changing the way rank works. There's going to be 12 ranks per side in the GCW system, 6 enlisted and 6 officers. Once a week, players' GCW points will be computed and their faction standing will modify accordingly. Players will advance through the ranks normally on the enlisted end, gaining rank with personal GCW participation. Once the players reach the officer ranks, they will begin to lose standing during the weekly updates. This increases the difficulty of advancement and dictates steady participation in GCW activities to maintain rank. There's a lot of people not happy with the way this works. Because once you're an officer, you can get up to general, but if you do not continuously PvP, you're going to lose rank. And they've talked about it being like a 40% reduction a week in your level, which some people have said is a bit too high. But what I was comparing to, I was talking about on the TGR boards with Cactus, and he was really cranky this week, so we'll let him pass. His baby's been keeping him up. But the one thing is, this amounts to basically endgame content. And if you just like level up to general, then what's there left for you to do? You get to general, bam, you're done. You have no incentive to continue PvPing. You're done.
Well, sure you do. If they're 40% a week.
No, I'm talking about, that's why they're adding something like the 40% decay, so you'll continuously do it. You know, it'll bring you back to it. There's a reason to keep going back. Because if they could just bring in, say, like a level 90 dungeon. They throw out a level 90 dungeon instead of this with chapter 3. You give it like a week or two, people are going to blow through that, and they're going to be back to the exact same point where they're going to be like, you know what, there's nothing to do in the game. We're bored. Now, so you know, content can come out, people can go through it, and then when that gets done, they can go back to the GCW, they can work their rank back up. It gives them something to do while they wait for the next piece of content to come out. It's kind of like, I would compare it to like a filler, you know, it's like, okay, do this until we can get the next piece of content. It gives you something to continuously do.
I agree.
Ranks will be displayed on the player avatar in the same fashion they are now, with the selection on the community page, and the rank title will appear above the character's name. I think that's good. Don't we all agree everyone kind of wanted to be able to display your rank?
Yeah, that was a big thing.
Now you can. On achieving enlisted and officer ranks, players gain the ability to purchase items from their faction recruiter. I hope it's a lot better stuff than what we previously had.
Whoa.
What?
Friggin' commando mines. Well, they better be in the next new system or I'm quitting commando. I will quit galaxies if mines go away.
No, you won't.
I will.
No, you'll quit galaxies, and then like a day before something cool will happen, you'll be like, oh man, I gotta re-up. I'm having the conversation with you now instead of like 2 months from now.
It won't happen that way this time.
Oh, it will.
I'll be going to the City of Heroes, and you'll never see me again.
Yeah, you'll play that for 3 days. At the officer level, players will gain access to character abilities and exclusive officer chat channels.
For the three officers, so yeah. Sushi has someone to talk to.
If a player eventually loses an officer rank through an activity, they will lose access to the officer channels and abilities, but will retain the ability to use any item rewards they have purchased. So you don't get penalized if you buy something and you lose the rank. Penalized. You can still use it. Penalized. Is that how I'm supposed to say it?
Penal.
Sounds dirty that way. The character page. A new tab will be added to the character page for the tracking of the GCW status. Character page will appear in similar fashion, and it just kind of breaks down your name, graphical progress bar, rank icon rank, GCW standing, PvP kills, GCW standing, highest rank ever. And then some of the frequently asked questions. How do I join a faction? And I don't know if I like this. They're removing the barrier to join a faction. You no longer have to have the 200 faction points. You just have to go up and talk to a recruiter. And you're immediately a member of the opposite faction.
So the people that were complaining about people, you know, jumping sides are now going to even get worse than that.
It seems like it's going to be easier.
Well, right, there might be something we don't know about yet.
There could be. You know, I would almost, instead of like just going up to talking to someone and being it, make it a mission that they have to complete. They have to go out maybe a series of missions. I'm not talking about like a whole legacy quest worth of missions. I'm talking about you go out there and run some missions, attack a bunker, blow something up. Bam, you can be part of the faction.
Well, maybe make it a time frame where every 24 hours you can't jump. I don't know.
I fear people will just be able to like go back and forth and hop between the factions, and hopefully they put in something that, you know, stops them from being able to do that.
Well, if they do that, they're not going to gain any rank anyway. Just ask around like that.
Yeah,
privates forever.
Stay away from privates. What is happening to Imperial and Rebel faction?
Were you thinking when you said that?
Yes, I was. Rebel and Imperial
faction. Windows.
Rebel and Imperial faction will be losing their fourth money status and will instead operate as any other faction by manipulating NPC reaction to your character. I want to see more of that. I miss just being randomly attacked by meat lumps as I'm driving around.
I don't.
You didn't like that?
I get sick of my stuff getting blown up.
bonus facts. What are the four types of money? Cash, bank, JTL, credit chips, and faction. How will I obtain factional equipment in the new system? After obtaining the proper rank, available items will be purchased with credits. So you no longer have to get the faction points to do it.
Ooh, cool. Money sink.
Yep.
Nice.
What will happen to my current faction rank? A lot of people are unhappy about this. The current faction ranks and ranking system will be removed. There's no conversion plan planned into the new system due to the ease of the game. Of gaming the old system. With the assistance of a smuggler, a new player could be a colonel in under an hour. Cactus made a good point. It takes a lot of money to be able to go from nothing to a colonel in an hour. Not that money's hard to come by in this game, but still there's people like him who ground each one of his people up to the colonel rank. And I would say at the very least, I mean, I agree that everyone should be wiped and start from the same place. You know, this is a completely new system.
Yeah. 3 years of inflation, I mean.
Yeah. You have a new system here. People are going to have to learn it. People should not have an unfair advantage where it's like, okay, I start off, you know, at this rank, and I get to, you know, play around, maybe die a few times. It doesn't hurt me as much as someone who just, you know, who's a lower rank. And I agree everyone should start from the same, but you should give them something, some kind of accommodation, a plaque, anything, you know, just to say, hey, you know, or maybe Elder Colonel tag.
Yeah.
Maybe somebody could.
Elder Colonel.
I don't know. Just something that says, hey, you know what? I achieved this rank in the previous system. So they can display at their house. And that's what people
Colonel
want.
Sanders. I give you a bucket of KFC.
Get a chicken. A chicken leg.
What's the matter, Colonel Sanders? Chicken?
Well, what happened to the rewards and items? Recruiters currently sell. Everything a faction recruiter currently sells will be offered in the new system. Commando mines, hello. All grand schematics are of the first tier, so line crafters will have access. Why did you use the army ranks? The Imperial and Army Alliance army rank structure had the greatest fidelity from enlisted officer. Does this mean we will see the return of the force ranking system soon? And they basically admit this is the old force ranking system they're using. So, they made modifications to point scoring rules, rank decay. There's no plans for competitive class-based rank system.
I wonder if we'll be bugged and you can go to the Enclave and vote yourself up the colonel. I'll try that when it goes live.
Just have elections. People can vote themselves.
That's why the old system didn't work.
How long will it take to advance in the new system? Currently at the max calculated advancement rate, we could see our first general in 16 weeks.
Wow.
It's a bit of an investment. Especially to lose, a player can lose a maximum of 40% of a rank per week. Well, that'd still take you, it'd take you almost 3 weeks to completely lose a rank. So, when you look at it that way, it's not that bad.
What if you get called to war? If you're going to Iraq?
Well, you know what? God bless you for,
I really don't care.
God bless you for going to Iraq, but it's a game.
I don't care. I'm here anyway.
If you're in Canada, come on, where are you going?
I don't know, France.
Yeah. At what rate do the officer ranks decay? We said 40% per week. How difficult is it to advance and maintain the officer ranks? And that's currently not known. So, guys, what are your thoughts? Flip. Overall, you like, you dislike?
Well, they are going to make it to where everybody starts out at the beginning, right?
What's that?
When people, the faction-wise, you know, everybody's that was once a colonel or whatever, you were saying that everybody goes to fresh new page, right?
Everybody's going to be the same across the board.
Right. I like that because everybody gets to start off. Nobody gets any bonuses, whatever. But I wouldn't mind seeing if they gave a little something to the side. I don't really even know how they would do that for somebody. For, you know, thank you for your time for investing and ranking up. Either you had, you know, 300 million and you could spend it all on your smuggler for getting you all the faction points, or somebody that actually ground that up. But I wouldn't mind if they gave something away. I don't know about Elder title because a lot of people complain about that stuff.
Well, one of the things people are a little unhappy about is forced PvP, and they're like, "What about the PvE game? You're not doing really anything. This doesn't incorporate the PvE game." And there's some with the ability to kill an elite NPC within 5 levels of you, but you know, really, those are hard to come by. I would like to see them tweak maybe the missions on, say, like Yavin or like one of the more dangerous planets, to incorporate, to make it easier for someone if they're PvE to be able to take a mission and go out and do those missions and be able, a little more consistently be able to get those higher level NPCs. You know, maybe not have the value as high because really there's not as much of a risk in going, you know, just going PvE and just killing some stuff. But, you know, just give them the ability to work up their rank slowly, you know, through a PvE system. And I think that's just basically, it would be through mission tweaks.
Yep.
Josh, anything? You want to say anything?
I don't think 2 months is too bad for leveling up your rank.
What about the 40% decay? You cool with that? Besides going to Iraq?
I kill people all the time going to Iraq. I don't follow up. I mean, yeah, it's no biggie for me. I'll work within that. I'm sorry, my throat hurts.
No problem. Hey, I think, you know, the main thing is the PvE, make sure those people are taken care of, and with the possibility of the player base is coming back. I really hope they tweak it, not so much, you know, the whole bioengineer thing, replacing it with one of the current professions, but make them a little bit different. You know, they're pretty boring the way they are now. It's like you go there, it's the same one, everything. Spice it up a little bit. I'd like to see maybe 3 or 4 different kinds of bases that people could drop, and maybe a planetary limit to encourage people to go out and bust some of the bases, you know, not just dropping all these in their city where there's a limit to how many there could be on a planet and having to go in there and take out some other people's before you can put yours down.
I like when people use the drop them in their city and put the 4 turrets up, then remove the base, and then do it again. And right by the shuttle port, you'd have like 12 turrets saving up the shuttle. Whoever came in over it was screwed.
Zap, zap, zap. Yeah, those were the good old days.
Those were the good old days. And I'll be back in 2 seconds and I'll eat some toothpaste.
Okay.
What? Toothpaste?
I'll be right back.
Just let him do his thing.
I think he's been drinking.
Yeah, probably. But this is just the basics of the GCW system. This wasn't meant for everyone's eyes. This was just a beginning stages. So don't get too up in arms if you're not happy with the way this looks. It could change over the next few weeks, and I'm sure when they're ready to reveal more, you know, specifics about how it's going to be, we will see something. But I just wanted to get the discussion started, and we could start, you know, talk about what we like, what we didn't like, and maybe they'll hear us and kind of direct things the way would like them to go.
Well, you know, a lot of times they always bring these kind of things up just so they can slightly change and modify, just in case something went horribly wrong in their thinking as to what we want.
Right.
What are we talking about?
Oh, just the GCW and how this is like an early build and don't get too up in arms over it.
Yeah, it's a design document.
Yeah.
It's only pen and paper.
Nothing's in game yet. Well, except for the PvE bases or PvP
bases.
Josh,
how come when you supposedly got your toothpaste, it sounded like a can opened up?
That was my door.
Nice door.
You mean this? Wait. That?
Yeah, nobody cares
about
it.
That's my door.
I'm moving on to the next topic. Just want to let everyone know, Stradix chat is going to be Wednesday.
You know, I logged in. I was waiting. I noticed that Hands, SOE, popped up. And then I noticed TH showed up. Next thing you know, they both left next week. I was a little mad because I was there waiting.
Why? It said right when they announced it that it was going to be August 30th.
Well, wasn't it a week ahead? It was supposed to be this Wednesday. That already passed.
No, when they announced it, they announced Wednesday, August 30th.
Then why did they show up in chat?
I have no clue. Maybe they had planned it for this Wednesday and then they put the wrong date down, but.
Maybe that's what they did because Hands and TH both showed up in chat on Stradix. And there were I don't know if there's 10, 15 people for about an hour already waiting, but people were in there waiting for them to show up, and they showed up, they left, and then when they left, I checked the boards, and then the next thing I know, it's next Wednesday, the 30th.
Well, I know Penty got all excited and posted in the TGR boards. He's like, Stradix chat tonight, and came back and like, isn't it the 30th? And he's like, yeah, sorry, working too hard, not awake yet.
Could have just been some dude using the name. I log on our chat all the time with this.
Well, no,
name.
Because they get the special option to co-op on top to be some sort of, I don't know if you want to call it avatar or whatever, but they show up as main users that can talk or whatever. I don't know what it is. I never go in there that often.
Yeah.
Well, here's the topics for this week's, and I want to make sure everybody knows. There's the officer expertise, the smuggler expertise, and the smuggler system. So, hey kids, when you show up, don't talk about Jedi this week. Let's let the officers and smugglers have their Stradix chat. And, you know, you probably asking GCW questions they're not gonna get answered. So let's stick to the officer smuggler and expertises and the smuggling system. Let's talk about those. Try to streamline the questions a bit for these guys. And hopefully they don't pick ones that don't fit.
Don't do it yourself, because they have a hard time doing it.
Yes.
They will take the short route and just answer the same question over and over. Like, when is Force Ranking coming back? They'll answer it three times, and that'll count.
Yes, you have an hour with them, so let's try to get the questions asked about the topics that are important. Not important, but that they want to talk about. Let's move on. Miscellaneous. We're going to talk about a little bit about the state of the game right now, and really this is nothing more than just a BS session between the three of us on our current thoughts on the game. Josh, this was your idea, so what do you want to talk about?
I'm happy.
Are you happy or are you just content right now?
I'm cautiously optimistically content. I like the fact we can look forward to publishers and not be afraid of them.
Yeah, I'm very happy with the way the publishes have been coming out lately. I mean, besides the whole Restus fiasco.
Fiasco. I look back on that and I had fun. Just getting mad.
And occasionally it's okay to do that, but then there's times where you want to be happy about, you know, things. And like chapter two was a pleasant surprise. I think it worked out even better than what we thought it would.
Chapter popped up mysterious on Test Center was nice. I wish more of those would happen. You know, the one that was cool?
Which one? You talk about two?
No, the chapter that just popped up and all of a sudden we had something new. I forget what it was. It was like the center camera.
Oh, yeah.
That was a good mini publish that just came out of left field.
Yeah, I'm really impressed with the way they're adding, you know, they're tweaking, bug fixing, adding stuff in between the chapters as well. You know, really getting that stuff out there and trying to clean up the game. I think that's really important. It doesn't matter how much cool stuff you add to the game. If people are running into a lot of flaws, you know, people are going to come back, they're going to hit, you know, have those issues, and they're going to get frustrated and they're going to leave again. So to clean up stuff as they go along, it's nice.
Yeah, and I just wish they wouldn't. I'm not going to harp on Jedi anymore. I just really hate them. I wish they'd stop. People should stop going Jedi. That's my comment.
Well, you know, people go Jedi because it's available, and you know what? That's what people want to do in a Star Wars game.
Yeah, but I'm morally against Jedi in the prequels, too. Okay, this is my little hate on Jedi here. The whole reason Jedi were cool back in the 70s and 80s in the old movies is because they didn't have to explain how these supposedly omnipotent people who were so cool got their asses kicked by stormtroopers. And the fact they went back and they had to explore that and made the Jedi look so ridiculously stupid. Like, they could sense the slightest emotional imbalance or when friggin' Padme's having her period on their side of the galaxy. But they didn't smell the friggin' million stormtroopers walking up their back door and shooting them in the ass. I'm just so mad with the prequels, I probably wouldn't care if I hadn't seen the prequel films, but the fact that those just ruined Jedi for me makes me hate Jedi and galaxies.
Well, you know, while we're harping on the prequels a little bit, you know what the thing that really pissed me off about it was the whole Jedi Council and, like, the Jedi Temple being, like, in the middle of friggin' Coruscant, you know, like, this big industrial city. It made no sense to me. I always picture, like, if I were to picture it, it would be, like, out in the middle of nowhere, where you'd have, like, this... It would be in nature, because they're supposed to be in tune... Like, I saw the Force was, like, nature, and they were supposed to be in tune with it, but to be...
Yeah, like the Enclaves.
Yeah, you know, like, out in the middle of nowhere, big temple, you know, a big training area. Not in like, friggin' Detroit. Because yeah, that's like, what it pretty much amounted to.
Logistically, it's a horrible place to put it. I mean, not to draw a comparison of real life, but something like a really easy crash of ship into that damn place and take out all the Jedi. I thought, like you said, it should be out in the middle of nowhere, like the Enclave from KOTOR or the ones in this game.
And they're so distrusting of the politicians, yet they're like walking hand in hand with these guys all the time.
And the fact that you want to see them all get their asses kicked when you're supposed to empathize with them just completely defies the point. It's a victim of its own creator, or it's a franchise that's been blown out of proportion. It's the same thing that happened with Star Trek. And people are like Battlestar Galactica, this is where it's going, people. They were smart. They started off with all their technology just being telephones and crap. I don't know what I'm talking about anymore. I'm sorry.
Yeah, and I think we're totally off the whole state of Star Wars galaxies. But I'm looking through here now. I have the published plan from April up. And I'm looking through, and like, what would be published 3 is Chapter 3 is published 31. And I'm looking at some of the stuff that they have in here. It's like the smuggler profession enhancements, the officer profession enhancements, the story missions, which I don't know if we're going to get those this time. The smuggling system is coming in, PvP ranks rewards, PvP in-game leaderboards. They also have updated adventure areas, Imperial Rebel theme parks, which supposedly they went through Jabba's, but... It doesn't sound like they did anything that interesting with Jabba's, and I hope like a pass on the Imperial and Rebel theme parks are a bit more interesting.
Don't midichlorians piss you off?
Midichlorians do piss me off, but that's a totally different topic. We'll do a state of the Star Wars IP and on a future show.
IP. That means like 4 things to me. Pick one.
No.
I'm mad now. Where's my toothpaste roll?
Well, don't get too mad, because as I'm looking through it, it looks like they're really on schedule to get a lot of the stuff done that they want to in-game. And Flip, what are your thoughts on the state of the game currently?
Well, first off, I'm wondering why he needs his toothpaste right now. And my other thought... Okay, another show. No, I see a whole bunch of hate on the chat or in the forums. People don't want to play the game. Just leave.
Oh, can't say that. I said that once.
Yeah, well, you know what? They're still hanging around. I don't get it.
Well, a lot of people prepaid for their year. Those should start running out quick. I say if it continues on after November, then you just have a bunch of people who have no lives. We're not dealing with them. They can do their thing. Sure, they ruin their boards. Hopefully when, you know, they make the switch over to the new boards, the moderators will be able to clean stuff up. They'll be able to get accounts out of there that... So people who aren't supposed to be posting can't post. But you know what? I'm ignoring them. Sure, they piss me off. I use the report moderator button if it pisses me off enough. But I'm not dealing with those people. That's their game, pretty much. They like to play the forums, so.
That's okay.
I like to play the. I like to play Texas Hold'em on Live Arcade.
Well, they can play the MMORPG board.
Yeah.
Which, by the way, aren't that bad.
No, there's a lot of cool cats there. No, well, no, there's people there. Sometimes I post about the show, and people listen to the show. They agree. I like to get their feedback too, because a lot of, you know, there are a lot of jaded gamers who aren't happy with the way that things have been handled by SOE, and you know, rightly so. They're angry. They're over at the MMO boards, and you know, I like to get their feedback too. You know, what do they think about something? Is the GCW the revamp going to be enough for them to come back? You know, some people are a-holes about it, but other people are more than willing to discuss it, so.
Jaded people.
Yes.
I'm jaded. I got a PM the other day from Raging Fart. Like, Rage on Bart, the guy in the Deathwatch bunker with the F on it, who just sent me a PM and says, I did the nasty, and that was all it was.
Okay.
That's the kind of crap I deal with. I'm jaded.
It's a lot better than people threatening to kill you in a boxing ring, so.
Oh, you know, by the way, I gotta ask about Super Shadow, Josh, later on.
Oh, he's a douche.
Okay, we're not going there, guys. Let's finish this up. Something in the next few months that's coming out that you look forward to. What would it be, Josh?
The new boards, I guess. They work.
What about in-game?
Commando stuff.
Commando stuff. That's all you care about.
That's all I care about, because it's a good profession.
You have two
good people.
You have after three, you have four. You're scheduled for five, it looks like, so.
Five?
Yep.
What about now? Two?
Yep. Should be getting, I would say we would be getting three in what? Probably see it in Test Center in 2 to 3 weeks?
I wouldn't even put that close. I'd put it somewhere in September.
Yeah, that would be in September, Josh. That would be probably the middle, around the middle to late middle part of the month.
Wait, what is today?
Today's the 26th.
27th, okay.
Yeah. So Flip.
Cool. Maybe in September.
Something in the future that you're looking forward to.
I'm looking forward to more of, if they're going to start incorporating PvP and those little bases on the planets, I kind of thought maybe a PvP zone would more look like a Corellian Corvette that crashed on the ground, and you got Rebels and Imperials fighting around, something like that, or maybe a Star Destroyer crashed on the ground, you got PvPers battling around that, not these set-up bases that are all kind of like seem perfect or something. I don't know, something like that.
There was a mission in Rogue Squadron 2, I think.
Yeah, but why...
Crash Star Destroyer.
Why would you be fighting in a Crash Star Destroyer? Unless you're trying to find something inside of it.
Maybe there's a mission that involves getting important information back from the Star Destroyer or the Corellian Corvette so the other side doesn't get it. I don't know.
It's called self-destruct buttons.
Well, you know, maybe somebody didn't think of that. I don't know.
Oh, man.
I don't think they had those in Star Wars. They're not cool.
Yeah, you know, it's, I don't know. I'm not getting into that. But,
we're really off the...
Yeah, really,
we're off the deep end tonight.
We're really off the mark with this topic. One thing that this topic made me think of is one of the other podcasts I listened to did this thing, and I wouldn't mind ripping it off because they ripped it off from Pardon the Interruption on ESPN. And basically what they did is they took a bunch of topics in a row, and basically they had a timer, and you had 3 minutes. So they would throw out a topic, they discuss it back and forth for 3 minutes, timer go off, they stop right there, go on to the next topic. And I think that would be kind of fun for us to do on here, is, you know, have the listeners give us a range of topics to talk about. And then when we get a big chunk of them, just do that and, you know, maybe go over four or five, you know, six topics and, give that a
whirl. Right now. We got nothing there to do.
Yeah, let's try that another week when we can get it prepared. Because we didn't prepare this SWG state of the game thing, and look how wonderfully this has gone.
Well, that's because you didn't log in Skype this morning. I got up, I was like, okay, I'll meet Barrick on SWG or Skype, and then we'll talk about what we're going to do for tonight, because this is the 50th episode.
Well, you know, I didn't even want to do the episode tonight, but you talked me into it, so Gavin might be here, so...
I didn't talk you into it, I told you I wanted to go to bed.
No, you talked me into it.
Okay, fine. Blame Gavin.
Okay, it's all Gyron's fault, and this whole segment's Gyron's fault. So, Friday Feature, Flip Freedom Station, this is you.
Alright, Friday Feature. Freedom Station. Then they go out, go about talking, and with, you know, you can now blow it up, and they have, let me see here, it's, near the planet Ord Mandel. Isn't that right?
What?
The Freedom Station? Freedom Station. Well, in the story here, they bring it on where they're talking about near the planet Ord Mandel, and they bring in this, story, this plot, get you back in thinking about the Freedom Station, and,
Deep Space is Ord Mandel.
Well, the story is. That's where they take place in the story. I was gonna ask something, but I didn't go there. Anyways, it's just a story, and then back down, at the end of the story, they explain to you how you can take it out, either the, Freedom Station, there are going to be, it's protected by NPC, Nova Courier and a Tier 5 fighters, and to destroy it, you have to do these certain things. And the same thing with the Imperial Star Destroyer, it's protected by NPC Decimator and Tier 5 fighters, and you have to do these certain things to bring it down. So, and they're just going back over that because now it's destructible.
Cool, good use of the feature. now that it actually works, hey, check this out.
It should have been just, it blows up as a passion.
All right, this week's TGR Star Wars Trivia Challenge. Let's give that out. We're emailing you, Josh, right?
Yeah.
Okay, so everybody get your email ready for josh@thegalaxyreport.com. Email him.
Sweet.
First one to email him will win a Rebel polo shirt. It's a nice black polo shirt. Has the Rebel logo on it. You look like a complete dork when you're out trying to pick up some ladies. So, Flip, it was your question. Do you want to ask it?
I want to hear you say it. Oh, well, actually, you know what? I do want to ask it.
Okay, you ask it.
Okay, here. I hid it away on my desktop. I don't know why I did that. Come on up here.
Tick-tock, tick-tock, tick-tock.
Yes, Microsoft Word is awesome. Okay, here we go. All right, the question is, during the Clone Wars, what did Alia Secura do to disguise herself while on an important mission to Corellia?
Ooh, it's a tough one this week, and Stetton is not eligible because he's already won two of these things. So, of course, I have his address saved into my shipping system now, so I can get the stuff out quick.
I'll get your hopes up, Stetton.
No, he already got the one from last week.
Oh, man, I've been waiting 3 months for mine. You suck for a guy who works in the shipping department.
I told you, you got stuck in customs. That's what happens for you not leaking the GCW information to me so I could put it on the show and get like a scoop on everybody. Okay, so first person to email the correct answer to josh@thegalaxyreport.com will win the Rebel polo shirt. So while we're waiting for Josh to receive the answer, we're going to move on to the poll question of the week. Last week's question was, would you approve of the removal of harvesters and factories? Just a little over 9% said yes. 54% said yes, but only if it makes it easier to add to the crafting game. And that goes back to Helio saying that right now it's a real bear to add anything to the game. It takes a day or two for a developer to add just one item into the game. And part of that has to do with the way the harvesting and the resources work. So that's some of the thought behind that. And, almost 37% said no, they do not want to see the removal of harvesters and factories. And some of the comments that were made that I plucked out from the forums were, one was from Dukas. He said, there's no way in hell he'd support this if it was only talking about the Burrower droid, that if you only received one, that he wouldn't be for it. You'd need at least 10 droids in the ground to make up for the loss of harvesters. And he also wanted to know about storage bins. If it was less than 50K, having droid harvesters, he couldn't handle it if, you know, it would totally depend on how many you could have and how much they could hold. So he also said having droid harvesters would be a superb addition to the droid engineer, and they will see a usefulness that has not been there since maybe the launch of JTL. And while I agree it does add to the droid engineers, it completely takes away from the big money makers for architects, so they're going to have to figure out some sort of balancing act there. Let's see, Stenton said, I don't mind harvesters being removed completely as long as there is an alternative that doesn't take up landscape and gives as many resources as needed compared to before. J-Mac said, I wouldn't mind seeing Harvey's go. Think of how many lots this would free up for most characters, so long as the resource requirements for schematics are in line with the new harvesting rates. He said factories could go too if they make it possible to craft, preferably, multiple crates of items by hand. And then Cactus said, honestly, the more I hear about the droid thing, the more I'd rather them just get rid of the searching for resources. If it ends up that only traders can use them, you could put them all in the same spot. Why bother with graded spawn points that you have to search for a sweet spot? You just land on a planet, check what's spawning, then launch the droids and leave. So that's some of the feedback we had on it.
I have to give Josh the answer again.
Okay. I probably wasted a lot of time trying to find a good spawn, but that was a little bit of the fun. You know, like I said, it was like a side game and stuff. I'd be crazy to think that, but I did.
You know, it's fun sometimes, but, I mean, how many times have you just decided to, like, plop them down all in one spot and then just pick the highest percentage of whatever's there?
You sent me the question, you tart. The answer.
You know, sometimes that's what I did. I popped them all back in my house over the pond, just set it up for that if I was in the mood.
Well, we'll see what they do with this, and hopefully, you know, the feedback will direct them, you know, try to do something that will benefit both, you know, will make the crafters happy and combat people happy. So, it leads into this week's question, and it has to do with the GCW information that came out. Do you like the direction of the GCW with the information that has been leaked so far? And this is pretty much a yes or no question. And of course, I'm going to start the thread on the TGR boards for you to discuss, you know, are you unhappy with the way PvE is incorporated in the system? Do you want to see player bases change a certain way? We want your feedback, that way we can incorporate it into this segment.
And hot dog, we have a wiener.
Who won?
Eric D. Bauer.
Sweet.
Congratulations on winning by default. Only two people that mailed.
What actually did they say, though?
Smugglers.
Yeah, we should probably give the answer. Disguise yourself as a smuggler.
Yeah, when the stuff a little wrong, I said that first, and basically what it is, I'll jump the answer.
Well, you're getting all choppy. No one can understand you right now.
Flip, yeah, you're
all
right, breaking up.
Go ahead, yeah. Do it.
Do what? I was just saying no one could understand what you were saying.
I said just go ahead and, you know, the answer.
Good, yeah. Shooting text.
Yeah, am I all choppy still?
Yeah.
Yeah, your mic's broken.
Something's going crazy.
Yeah. Say at the end of the show.
Yeah, we're getting there. I do want to announce something that I want to give a whirl. It'll be the TGR Star Wars Trivia Challenge that I want to start getting contestants for. What I'd like to do with that is I'll put the rules all up on the board, but what I want to do is almost like an NCAA bracket style contest where we'll get like we'll see how many people volunteer to be part of this, but we'll pit two people at a time against each other, and it'll be like six questions, and they'll go back and forth trying to answer the question, and we'll have like a whole winner thing, and they'll move up in the bracket to the ultimate TGR Star Wars Trivia Champion. And I'm still working on the prize package, but I'm sure I'll include a shirt. We'll throw in a 60-day game card, and we'll see what else I can get my hands on before then. And I'm still trying to finalize everything. I am working on something else to add in.
Yeah. Throw in the thong.
A TGR thong.
Where did you buy those?
I didn't buy anything. That's if people want to buy them. But I'll get all the information about that up. You guys want to take a couple? Actually, we only have one question because Cactus seems to have disappeared on Skype. But if Decay gets re-implemented, what precisely will be the incentive for crafters to repair stuff rather than just let it decay to uselessness and sell replacement stuff?
That's a good question.
Well,
why would you not be a dick and make more money?
Well, you know what? You got a point. How can I argue that? The way I look at it, everybody will have their price. So someone comes up to you with the right amount, it's like, hey, you know what? I'll give you 100,000 credits if you repair this belt. You're probably going to repair it. Because it's more than you're going to get for selling another belt.
I'm Man, we got an educated listener who knows what he's talking about. I know.
How can we screw everybody over?
What can we do now? Well.
Awesome.
Touche.
Oh, wow.
Well, we got a good question for a change. You don't know how to answer it.
I know.
Well, people always remind you want to come back for episode 51.
Yeah. Do you have any questions you want answered? For once, we're not running long. We actually have a couple minutes to spare.
It's been a slow week, like you said. I don't think there's anything to talk about.
Yeah, hopefully.
Let's not do like we used to do and just run it until the mandatory hour goes by.
Okay, we'll wrap it up. I want everybody to make sure they fill out the bug wiki. It's been really slow in there. I haven't had anything to send into Rogue 5. But you run the bugs in game. Make sure you throw it into the wiki. That way we can track it, help them get the information. And, you know, Cactus has been really good about putting stuff in there, kind of cleaning it up. And I think at some point we're going to have to go through and check what's actually in there and see if it's been fixed or not and move it to the correct page. That way we're only sending in the latest and greatest issues or things that maybe we haven't logged before. So check out the bug wiki. Link's at the top of the little toolbar in Galaxy Report. So check that out. Donations, we're always taking donations. $2 a month if you want to do the recurring subscription or any amount that you want to donate our way. We can get wind mics I think we need because someone keeps breathing pretty heavily into the mic and it's making me kind of happy. So, you know, anything you see all goes towards the show, improve sound quality, maybe get a couple fans to... We'll get you a quiet fan, Josh. That way you don't get too hot during the show.
Get me an airflow mouse and I'll be fine. You give me two of them, I'll stick them underneath my armpits.
Oh, cool. What else do we have, guys? We have that.
It's a pleasant image for you.
Yeah, I'm totally ignoring that. But, I don't know. I'm missing something. I always miss something. You have questions for us, you can email us at thegalaxyreport.com. I want to thank Cactus for modding our boards this week. Not the boards, but the chat. Getting the questions. One question, it actually turned out to be a damn good one, so thanks to Cactus for that.
Cactus is back.
Yes, he's back with a vengeance. And then, Josh, Flip, thanks for joining me this week. And maybe one week we'll be able to convince Gyron to come back.
He's lazy. He makes me look good.
I know. We love him, though. But I think that wraps it up, so we will see you all next week.